us now is we don't want to go all the way around. We want to show you an alternative method of moving the turntable. This is because not every engine that comes on here has vacuum brakes. So, for instance, when the Tyne Scotsman came in 1999, it only had air brakes at that time, so it couldn't work the turntable. So we have to do it by the following method, which we're now going to show you. This pole can be pulled out. We're not going to do it today because it's a bit stiff. There's one on either end. And with the two hand wheels there, which drive through the same plane as the vacuum motor, we can move it. They want to go the long way around, I'd say. We didn't want to do it particularly. Yes, yes, it does, hooray. Well, it was mentioned in the back of the thing, quite why. But anyway, so pan line was visited in 1986. There's a painting of it, so you might find in the building you just walked through now. So, but in 1993, turntable was threatened with removal. And then the railway came in, and the Yeovil Railway Centre began by offering servicing facilities for mainline steam specials. That was the seemed to be a growing thing in those days. And to that end, we've got the turntable going again. We also bought from Glastonbury the large water tower you see there that came in dips. So that's from more than the work that's been demolished. That's between Glastonbury and State. And that was the first big job in 1994, taking this down, bringing it over here. until the next 5 or 6 years to do. And also we're building the main engine shed, which is a good building at the other end of the car park, which is something we've been around already, I see, and we're welcome to come around again and have a little look, or come be ready when it's been shown and turn around. And more recently we've acquired what we call the transfer shed, that's this building we've just walked through now. And that is so called because it was the built in the 1860s. To transfer freight from broad gauge Great Western trains. The Great Western was different to everyone else. They wanted 7 foot gauge between rails, not 4.5 that we have now. So this is what Brunel's doing, and today is Athens' birthday, in case you didn't know. Happy birthday, Isambard, as you might say. And I'm a bit of a nuisance because you don't think you'd like having their goods transferred on the route because it causes damage and loss and so forth. And inconvenient for all the handling. But that only lasted until mid-1870s when the broad gauge was taken out of this area and it was all standard gauge. Thereafter it became the Great Western Clifton Maybank branch. And it was called the Great Western Clifton Maybank of the Great Western. That's named after the big house you might see through the trees there on your right as you go down. And rehearsals as well. So, all sorts of things to